Carlos, and in this video, I'll show you how to set up multiple machines in RenderBots, and we'll send our first render. We'll start here, and this is a fresh install of RenderBots, so if you go to the Machines tab, you can see this is the only one. So let's prepare it for multiple machines, and this shouldn't take long. The first thing I'm going to do is go to this menu, Multiple Threads and Machines, then go to Set Multiple Machines, and it will ask me if this is the first computer or if I already have set other machines. Since this is the first one, I will select that. Then it sends me to the next page, and here it will ask me to choose a work folder. And this folder has to meet these conditions, which are pretty simple. It has to be a folder in the network that all the render machines can access, and all the machines need to have read and write permissions to that folder. Makes sense, right? If I choose a folder that is not in the network, like the desktop for example, RenderBots will warn me. You can use network map drives. For example, in this case, drive Q is actually a map network drive. And you can use those if you like, and it should be fine for most people. Especially if all the machines have the folder mapped the same way, so all the machines have the same letter for that folder. However, they do tend to be less reliable than using the direct path. So let me show you what happens. I'm gonna create my work folder here, and I'm just gonna call it RenderBots work folder. Cool. And if I hit OK, RenderBots tells me this is a network map folder, and it will suggest me to change the path to the full address. I'll click yes, and it will change it. Now that we have a folder selected, I'll just click next, and that's it for this machine. Now I just need to point all the other machines to the same folder. And to make that easy, you can either copy the path to the clipboard and send it whichever way you like, or you can check this option. And that will email me the instructions with the path of the folder that I used. So I'll check that and click finish. Let's move on to the next one. Now we're in a different machine. I'll open the email that it sent. And this includes all the instructions in case someone else is setting up the other machine, so you can just forward him or her this email. And it will probably also include a link to this video, but since I'm recording this video right now, it's not there yet. All right, let's open RenderBots. And we'll go to the same assistant via the Multiple Threads and Machines menu, then set Multiple Machines. Since this is the second machine, we'll click on this other button now. And it will ask me for the folder that we selected on the first machine. I can either navigate to it via this button, I could type it here, but since I have the email, I'll just get it from there. So I'll select it, copy. Now I go back to RenderBots, and I'll just click this button to paste from the clipboard. Then hit next, and done. Cool, and that's it. If we go now to the Machines tab, I'll close this window, and here you can see that the other machine is here. Now, to add more machines, you just rinse and repeat. All right, now that we have our machine set, let's send a render. And this is pretty much the same process as when you only have one machine. I'll just go to After Effects, add my comps to the render queue, then send to RenderBots. And you can see on the file queue that it added it. So to start it, I can just click here, then select all machines online. And it tells me how many there are. So I'll click that. And that's kind of it. From here on, it's like any other render, and it should be faster, of course. And by the way, each machine can have several threads as well. So if you have, I don't know, 5 machines and 3 threads on each, you're basically rendering with 15 threads. And if we go to the Machines tab, you can see which machines are doing what. And that's it. As with any other render, you can open the render files, folders, etc. If you open the report though, you can see which machines were involved in this render. And that's it. That's the basics. If you want to know more about multi-machine rendering and controlling other machines and other little more advanced stuff, there's another video where we go deeper into it. The link for that should be in the description and the end card as well, so make sure to check that out if you're interested. Otherwise, I'll see you in the next video.